to another episode of the Movie Brothers, where we bring you nothing but the real on the real. I'm Ant, and this is Kev.
What's up?
On today's show for you, we're going to review the movie Ender's Game. Ender's Game is rated PG-13, has a runtime of 1 hour and 54 minutes. It's an action-adventure flick, and the premise of this movie is after an alien attack on Earth that kills millions of people, a new military unit is built around kids to prepare for a future attack.
This movie was directed by Gavin Hood. You probably know his work from X-Men Origins Wolverine,
yep.
If you've seen that.
Which I happen to love.
And you loved it,
yep.
Me not so much, but that's neither here nor there. The movie stars Harrison Ford, no introduction needed, Asa Butterfield, who you may have seen his fine work in Hugo, or perhaps in The Boy in the Striped Pajamas. The movie also features Viola Davis, Oscar-nominated actress, very good, very solid in everything that she's in. The movie also features Hailee Steinfeld, another young up-and-coming actress who was also Oscar-nominated.
And with that said, let's take a look at the trailer.
All right.
Okay. All right.
When the aliens first invaded, they nearly destroyed us. They will be back. There's greatness in you, Ender. The world needs you. You were bred for this. You see things in a way we can't. You alone can understand the enemy. You will be the one to save mankind.
He's not ready.
You're never ready. Even when you're ready enough.
Track them from below the ice. Shoot straight. Stay calm. Here we go.
Fire!
Everything I can to win this war.
If you succeed, you will be remembered as a hero.
He's abandoning his entire fleet.
He's in command. There's no stopping him now.
In 3, 2, 1, now!
All right, y'all. So in this game, as Kev mentioned earlier, you know, we got an all-star cast here of Oscar-nominated actors. And I have to say, I was a little bit disappointed in terms of the performances based on the caliber of actors that are in the movie.
Oh, yeah, you can't throw a rock without hitting somebody who was nominated somewhere in this film.
Exactly, exactly. So I'll just start with Harrison Ford. Mm-hmm. You know, I felt like his performance was as sleepy as a Sunday afternoon for the most part. I mean, he was just so numb and just neutral in everything. I mean, very little emotion, and, you know, that was a problem for me.
I'd have to agree with you. As much as I love Harrison Ford, as you can see over Ant's shoulder here, Indiana Jones is part of my life, all right?
Yep.
But the bottom line is that Harrison Ford really has kind of, you know, I hate to say he's been mailing it in over the past 30 years or so, but the bottom line is that I have not seen him really stretch in a way that he did earlier in his career, even post-Star Wars, Indiana Jones, with films like Witness and so on and so forth. But the bottom line is that he doesn't really deliver much in this film aside from just being Harrison Ford.
I agree. So we also have Viola Davis in this movie, which, you know, Viola Davis, you know, she's a pro.
Yes,
and,
absolutely.
You know, her performance in this movie was no different. She looked great as well. But I will have to say, you know, it was hard for us to see her shine because there was so little to her character. Right. I mean, she didn't have anything to work with.
Right. There really wasn't a whole lot of meat on the bone for her to really play around with. The character that she's playing was actually a male in the book. And a lot of that character's story arc has been really stripped away from this film. So I don't know if it has more to do with the script than anything else, but she really didn't have much to do.
Yeah. No, I hear you. And we have Asa Butterfield, who's the main character. He is Ender. And I have to say, with this kid, I just could not follow him. I could not follow him. He, you know, some actors have it and some don't. And maybe he does in some other work that he's done.
Right.
But I just did not see him pop on the big screen. And so he left me very bored watching him in every scene that he was in, with the exception of, you know, there's some scenes where he gets angry.
Uh-huh.
And you know, things hype up, you know, get hype a little bit.
Right.
But beyond that, not much there.
I'm a big fan of Asa Butterfield. I think that he has a very refreshing, honest look, okay, as far as actors go. I like the work that he's done in previous films that I've seen him in. I just don't think he was given a whole lot to chew on script-wise in this film.
And with that said, you have a terrible supporting cast of kids. Not trying to dog out kids, but
we love the kids.
The movie brothers love the kids. But I've never seen that many poor child actors. Oh, so, Kev, what did you think about this movie?
You know what? As much as I really wanted to love this movie, I just couldn't, okay? And you have to understand, this book has formed the basis of a lot of people's childhood. I mean, this is the 1985 Hugo Award-winning novel for science fiction, 1986 Nebula Award winner. People all over the world adore this book, but I think it was given a short shrift here on the film.
Yeah, and you know, with that, I was left with just a bunch of cliche boot camp, military, aliens come to Earth.
Honestly, cliches. I wish we had gotten more of that, honestly, because there's more of it in the book that Ender has to go through that we never even see in the film.
Well, they should have brought that to the screen because, I mean, what they put out there, we've all seen this. Yeah. We've all seen this, and it comes off as very, very corny, you know, and then, you know, they snag from Independence Day, you know, the F-16 fighter jet up the rectum of the alien mothership.
Hello, boys, I'm back.
And that's not a spoiler. That's kind of backdrop
for
the storyline. So I'm not giving anything away, but it was terrible.
Yeah. This movie really deserved a better adaptation. And with that said, you ready to put some points on this?
Let's throw some points on it.
Okay.
So for me, I give this movie a 4 out of 10. It's not very good. I would not recommend that you see it. If I'm trying to tell anyone to maybe go see it, I would say, you know, your 11-year-old son or nephew or whatever, to take him to go see it, and I'd be curious to know if he liked it, and if he did, I would like him to tell me what he enjoyed about it.
You know what? I did take my 11-year-old son to go see it, and he was fairly amused by it. I don't think it really held his attention all that well.
So he wasn't crazy about it.
Wasn't crazy about it. He didn't hate it, but he wasn't crazy about it. I would give this movie a 5, and that's just based on the fact that I have so much respect for the original source material.
Right.
But as an actual film, I probably would rate it closer to where you are. Okay. I think that if you are a fan of this book, if you have read Orson Scott Card's Ender's Game, you will probably bring that baggage with you into the movie theater, and you might forgive a lot of the omissions and the things that you don't see on film. But otherwise, if you've never seen this or never read this book before, you will probably be bored to tears.
Yeah. Well, there you have it. We are the Movie Brothers, where we bring you nothing but the real on the real.
Peace.